Okay, I'll make a little video here. We're going to go over top 5 smokeless powders that I use. It was actually fairly difficult to kind of decide on 5. 10 would be a lot easier. Actually, I'd probably go 20. But I don't know. There's quite a few, but and I don't even know all of some of the, like some of the manufacturers never used some kinds of powders, so. But, and this is no way a video saying like, oh, this powder is better than that powder or whatever. This is personal preference. This is stuff that I've used since like the start, since I started reloading like, I don't know, 20 years ago or whenever it was. So, and some of them are sort of nostalgic kind of powders, like some of the ones you kind of use the ones you start with and you kind of stick with them because you're familiar with them, have a long history with them, you know what they do. It's kind of like, you know, having a wrecky old car. You know, it's all of its problems and what it can do. If you buy another old wrecky car, then you inherit all kinds of new problems you don't know about, kind of thing. Or something. I don't know. Anyway, you know, I'll try to show them in order of that I use them or something. I don't know if I can remember, but so. Probably number one would probably be IMR 3031. It's a really dependable sort of medium burning stick powder. It's old, it's been around like, well, the 3031 designation I think has been around since like 1937 or something like that. Or earlier, I forget. It was in the 30s, I believe. But there was another powder that was like 17 and a half or something or other they called it. But it was been around a long time. It's you can use it in pretty much any kind of medium-sized cartridge, most military cartridges and stuff. So there's other ones that are similar to this, but I picked this one because it's one I started with. So, and you can't really go wrong with it. You can load most stuff with it. You can load bigger magnums and stuff, and it's just, you know, like it's not the best for it, but you can use it for a lot of things. So, got that one. Next big one is I get to use them at the same time. So actually, if you had a top two, that these probably would be it. You could do worse, but unique. It's a Liant, but it was Hercules when I started using it. And still got the little dude on there, I guess, but. This is sort of like a flake pistol shotgun powder. Mentions on there. It even says the most versatile powder made. So you can use it in handgun, you can use it in shotgun loads, you know, cast loads. There's not a whole lot you can't, you know, it's not for full power like rifle loads because it's too fast, but. You can do a lot worse. It's an old standby. So as I said, you can kind of do worse if you had, these out of the way, they're blocking the light here. You can do a lot worse than unique. So, next one, I'll go with this one, I guess. Liant 2400, but it was Hercules 2400 as well. It's sort of a magnum pistol powder. I don't know if it's like a flake or a slice stick or what the sort of the, but it sort of almost looks like kind of a flake powder or almost looks like a ball, but it's not, I don't think. But I guess according to their website, it originated for 22 Hornet. So it's really good in small capacity cartridges, you know, 44 Magnum. You know, sort of Elmer Keith's kind of go-to powder in the old days. It's been around a long time. You can use it for like cast bullet loads. You can even says for 410, load that with it. That's just great for 44 Magnum and for high velocity kind of Magnum pistol loads and stuff. So it's kind of one you kind of got to have it in there. Some of these ones you just can't not have them there. They're just so good. And we gotta have something a little bit slower in case you want, you know, bigger capacity stuff. This is Hodgen 4350, but I was thinking IMR 4350, but I don't think I have a can of it. That's not, they all rot it through, or, but, like the IMR one, I kind of used that a long time ago when I had 300 Magnum, went through a lot of that, but it's good for all kinds of stuff. 3006, the bigger, like 270, the bigger cartridges, you can use it. Use it for cast bullets in 3030. Like, I was thinking 4831 as well, but you gotta pick one or the other when you only get five choices, so. But maybe we'll have an expanded version or top 10 here sometime, but. So this is a good slow powder. You can use it in magnums, like current magnum, stuff like that. And for cast loads, like full. Sort of case cast loads almost, but the Hodgen one's similar. There is a little bit of differences, I guess, but this one's actually made in Scotland. It's kind of weird, but they had a bunch of, like, Hodgen was selling, it says newly manufactured, because they were selling like surplus and a bunch of different powders for like a long time. I'm not sure how long it took them to sell it all off, like decade or more or whatever, but he's got like 4831 and like that they sold surplus, so there was tons of this stuff left after the war, like stuff that wasn't loaded, and then I guess they tore apart a bunch of cartridges and got powder out of them and stuff at different times. So, and this is number 5, IMR 4227. It's kind of hard not to put this one in the top 5. It's fairly, what the, I guess the fastest stick powder that IMR makes. Where's my book here? Let's see where it shows on the burn chart. So you got like 4227, and then you got, see, it's just a tiny bit slower than like 2400 at Courtwell in the list, so it's not really, I don't use this as load data or anything, but that's like faster than like, you know, 4198, stuff like that, so it's, but you can use it in like magnum pistol loads, you can use it in like for cast loads, like for the self-loading, is pretty much the go-to powder for like 35 and 401 and 351 and those kind of ones. You can kind of get away with 2400 as well, but I've seen data for this, but I've never used it. I've gone with this, but so it's kind of a, for, there's some other like really small little rifle cartridges and stuff, you can kind of like, you know, like 3220 or probably use it in like 4440 or I don't know. There's a whole bunch of, it's quite fairly fast powder, so you can kind of get away with using it in a lot of small cases and stuff. So it's kind of one you got to have, but because some of these are kind of like, well, I could, you know, there's other powders that are better at certain things, but you kind of have trouble dropping one of these to replace it with another, so that's why I was saying it was a top 5 is actually fairly difficult. Might do a top 10 sometime, but I was thinking maybe a top 5 like discontinued powders or something, because there's quite a few ones that I like or I've used in the past that are actually discontinued now. Like 4759 comes to mind. They've sort of, I guess they dropped that, and that was like a really good powder for certain applications, like for cast and stuff. It was king, but some of these other ones you can use, and then now that we've kind of been messing around with the slow powders for cast and stuff, you get a good case fill, and then you get a around 2,000 feet per second, which is pretty much your good upper limit for most cast bullets, but you know, for just run-of-the-mill wheel weight jobbies and stuff. But so anyway, so drop your top five down below if you want, or make a video even if you want. There's no video response, but I suppose I could make a playlist or something. So, anyway, thanks for watching, guys, and we'll talk to you later.